Got it, okay. I'll put the dress, so I don't have to find it. We're gonna put it in the
What do you think? It goes on the right. On the right, okay, but not the tarnish, not...
Yeah,
like this. Like this, right.
Jennifer, come here. Not like that, down more. Not like a baton.
Yeah.
There he is, Theo! Let me get him right here. I don't have to put it on.
I don't either.
Hold it up.
Theo?
We must love each other. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Hail
forsaken us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. And now let us pray. Father, hear our prayers from Mark and Sabrina, who today united in marriage before your altar. Give them your blessings and strengthen their love for each other. And we ask this in the name of Christ our Lord. Amen. And now would you please be seated for the readings of this matter.
For the higher gift, and I am going to show you the way that is better than any of them. If I have all the elegance of man or of angels, but speak without love, I simply a gong booming or a symbol of passion. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding and mysteries, there are in knowing everything. If I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all of the that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn, but I am without love, it will do me no good whatsoever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense, and it does not resentful. It's not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse or to trust, to hope and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. This is the word of the Lord.
Happy is the man. Happy are those who do what the Lord commands. Happy are those who do what the Lord commands. Happy the man who fears Yahweh by joyfully keeping his commandments. Children of such a man will be powers on earth. Descendants of the upright will always be blessed. Happy are those who do what the Lord commands. There will be riches and wealth for his family, and his righteousness can never change. For the upright he shines like a lamp in the dark. He is merciful, tender-hearted, and virtuous. Happy are those who do what the Lord commands. Interest is not charged by this good man. He is honest in all of his dealings. Kept safe by virtue, he is ever steadfast and leaves an imperishable memory behind him, with constant heart and confidence in Yahweh. Happy are those who do what the Lord commands. He need never fear bad news. Steadfast in heart, he overcomes his fears. In the end, he will triumph over his enemies. Happy are those who do what the Lord commands. Quick to be generous, he gives to the poor. His righteousness can never change. Men such as this will always be honored. Happy are those who do what the Lord commands.
My dear friends, in the presence of God, Mark and Sabrina have come here to join hands, and in doing so become one for the glory of God, for the good of their fellow human beings, and for the needs of each other. They are here in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen their love in the presence of this church's minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you with a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. When they leave here today, they will be as they were when they came, equal in every way, and yet different, because they will be equal parts of each other. So now, in the presence of the church, I ask you both to state your intentions. Have you come here freely and without reservations to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God if it is His will for you, and raise them according to the law of Christ and His church? I, Mark, take you, Sabrina, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you, in good times and in bad, sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. I, Sabrina, take you, Mark, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you. Lord, bless and consecrate Mark and Sabrina in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love. Lord, bless these rings, which we bless in your name. Grant that those who wear them may always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will and always live together in peace, goodwill, and love. Thank you. pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That you will grant them a sense of value, so that they will care more for people than for possessions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That their home may be filled with peace and Christ-like hospitality. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That they may be an example of service to the needs of mankind, and may be an inspiration to their families and friends. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the relatives and friends of Mark and Sabrina, for those present, for those who cannot be with us, and for the faithful departed of their families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we offer you these petitions this afternoon. If they are in accord with your will, we ask you to grant them in the name of Christ our Lord. Now would you please be seated for the offertory prayers of this man. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, you have this bread to offer, the cherry that's given in human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Remember that his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, this life-giving bread, the saving cup. Thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love together with John Paul, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles and all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Now, would you please stand as we present ourselves in prayer to the Father, you who were Jesus' name.
We ask this in the name of Christ, our Lord.
said to your apostles, I leave you peace, and my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you all. Now let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away
As you have made Mark and Sabrina one in this sacrament of marriage, so now make them one in love for each other. We ask this in the name of Christ our Lord. Final blessings are a twofold blessing. First one is from the American Indian ceremony. The second one is from our church ritual. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you is shelter for the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you is warm to the other. Now there is no more loneliness, for each of you is companion to the other. Now you are two bodies, but there is only one life before you. Go now to your new home to enter into the days of your togetherness, and may your days be good and long upon this earth. May God the Almighty Father give you his joy and bless you. Amen. May the only Son of God have mercy on you in good times and in bad. Amen. May the Holy Spirit of God fill your hearts with his love always. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. This Mass is now ended. Go in peace.
Sorry.
Cecilia, make sure we get everybody the shot you want. We got everybody in the shot that you want. Make sure to stay up here with me.
Here, Grandpa.
Yeah, she's coming.
Is that right? She laughed when I told her. Hi, dog.
This is Bay Garcia and Miriam Podella. Right here. And next, I'd like to introduce you, Linda.
Attaboy, Ralph.
Michelle.
Get it, girl. Hold that flag straight.
Thank you. this time or like the rest of the wedding party. We go again. Let's give a round of applause for Mark and Savannah Garcia.
Look at these eyes.
officer. So we're not in this room. Okay, now back to the food situation. Okay, section to my right, the people that are seated to my right will come forward. The people to the left will go to the center, and the bridal party will go to the center also. So this will be all after the bridal party has started. The back section, you will go to the back table back there, and that way you all can form your lines. But please, let the bridal party first. Thank you.
Yeah. each other. Don't even look at me. I'm going to tell you, all right? Ready, set, go.
Okay. Everybody, hold it.
She would get dangerous.
Por aquí.